I feel like the commonly held view about Yakuza for the PlayStation 2 is that it's a flawed gem. So pretty much that if you're willing to overlook the flaws of the game, it's going to feel like a masterpiece. And it is something that you wouldn't really see. It hasn't been hyped to be mainstream. So if you look at it and you get into the niche of this game, people argue that it's like amazing masterpiece that you'll get to experience. I think this is a really valid point about Yakuza. It makes a lot of sense, but my personal feeling is a bit different. To me, I view it as a failed prototype. Now, okay, so the word failed in there is going to make it seem like I hate the game. And no, that's not the case. It's really, what I mean to say is that most of the time when I play this game, I was thinking, man, I can't wait to play the sequel. That's what I mean. What I mean is that there's so many flaws in this game and so many issues. But if we fixed it here and there, this could be a phenomenal game. There is so much potential for this game. And playing this in 2009, I already know that there's a sequel and, you know, that's released. So I was just dying to beat this game to move on to the sequel and see how it's improved. Because really the potential of this game, especially the storytelling, and just the mechanics themselves, there's a lot of problems with it, but you know, if they just streamline a lot of it bit by bit, it could be a really great game. And you know, reading about all this stuff about Yakuza 3 and the upcoming Yakuza 4, it really feels like Sega really addressed a lot of like issues here. And many of the issues have to do with technical issues, like the loading times. There's a lot of loading times to get past in this game. Every time you walk like 5 steps, there's a loading to a different scene, different camera angle. There's loading every time you get random encounters. There's loading time every time you get out of random encounters. There's loading time in between cutscenes. There's loading time to get to the menu screen. It's ridiculous. But at the same time, it kind of makes sense. Going back to the time this game was made, I think it was 2004, this game looks really amazingly good. You know, the graphics are really good. It actually sometimes feels like you're actually in Tokyo, or whatever the Japanese city this game is based on. So that's really cool. It feels vibrant. Although, a lot of times, you're playing at nighttime in the game, so it's a bit too dark. I didn't really like that too much. I wanted to feel, you know, wanted to see the city in more clearly, but it was way too dark and often too muddled, which is, you know, I guess the method they used to make the graphics seem awesome. But that was, you know, I didn't really like that too much. But at the same time, the game looks really great, especially the cutscenes. Cutscenes are pretty amazing stuff, and I mean for a PS2 game of that time, really too. And the story is great. It kind of has a little bit of a slow pace. It's still a really good pace, I think. It has a lot of intrigue. It's about a Yakuza group. One person in particular, he's considered the dragon of the Dojima family, which means he is a badass who can kick anybody's ass, really. And he does in the story of the game. But one day, his best friend and the girl that his best friend and him both love end up, you know, killing the head of their family because, you know, it's a complicated thing. But anyway, so because the main character cares about his best friend, he takes the blame for himself and gets in prison for 10 years. And 10 years later, he comes out of the prison and the whole world that he known has changed. And that's where the story picks up, and it's pretty intriguing stuff. I mean, there's some problem-like instances, but really, I think the story of this game is the hallmark of this game, is what makes this game so strong and have a really great potential. And I think the story is the reason why there has been able to be so many sequels to this game, because it carries on, and you feel for this character. This character is really cool, but more than the character, this story is really about this little girl. The story really centers around this little girl, and in an unexpected way, because she has a lot of connection with this 10 billion yen that everyone is searching for. Of course, 10 billion yen is not the only issue, but it's one of the main issues. And just, you know, because I think the story is really great, I actually plan on making a video that shows the entire, like, the last two chapters. Just, you know, it's going to be spoilerific. If you guys don't care about spoilers and you guys want to check it out, I'm definitely going to make a video on that. So that's going to be cool. So the story aspect is pretty cool, even though the ending is really problematic. It just, like, feels so abrupt. So much happens in the last chapter that just feels like, you know, it just felt like, okay, we're almost done with this game, let's just finish it with this last 13th chapter. I think they could have done a lot better with the ending. But then again, I'm kind of glad at the same time, because it gives me a chance to move on to the sequel really fast. So I'm definitely excited to play Yakuza 2 as soon as possible. Okay, so that's the story, really. And it's kind of... I feel like I can talk about story and gameplay in this game pretty separately, because they are separate parts. The gameplay, as I mentioned, has a lot of technical issues, such as the loading times. There's also the issue of the combat system itself, which is way too simplified. There is a little bit of depth on the surface. You can learn new combos, you can earn experience points to level up and get more techniques, and increase your health bar and all that kind of good stuff. But really, a lot of the new combos are not useful at all. Most of the time, and you'll see in this video, that my character does the same moves all the time, and that's because it's the most effective combo, and it's really like the only combo to use, which is square, 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 triangle, triangle. And he does, you know, punch, punch, kick, round kick, and slam kick, and, you know, and then when the button prompt pops up, push triangle, and he does a special move. I mean, that's really all I needed to do. And because the character has a tendency to just go straight, he doesn't lock onto an enemy character. Your main character, Kazuma Kiryu, he just goes straight. The hit detection is off, making the combat a bit... There is nothing to really... Sometimes a lot of the games, you get better as you practice. With Yakuza, I don't really see that as a case. I just see the mechanics as kind of flawed, so that no matter how many times you play the game, you're not really going to improve. It's the system that's broken, not you, you know? So gameplay wise, it wasn't very fun. I really just played it for the story. And I think the sequel addresses a lot of the gameplay issues. And if that's the case, then I think I'm really going to love Yakuza 2. Yakuza 1, I see it as a prototype. I see it as something that tries to mix in RPG mechanics with great story action cutscenes, with brawling type game, you know, just a throwback to the old school brawlers, like, I don't know, like Final Fight in 3D form, which is pretty cool, but at the same time, it's not as good as it could have been, which is why I say it's a failed prototype. So that is my thoughts on Yakuza. It's a pretty cool game to check out, and I can't really wait to see what the sequel is like.